everyone. Well, I'm back in my indoor garden today. Just wanted to give a little update on how my indoor tomato and cucumber plant are doing. Now, as some of you might know, I'm trying to grow an indoor tomato and cucumber all the way from seed to harvest. So they're actually doing pretty well. There's some exciting things happening over here, but there's also a few little glitches that I wanted to share with you. On the last update I did, we talked about hand pollinating, because obviously we don't have bees inside, so our plants need to be hand pollinated. They're growing indoors. So we hand pollinated both plants. Now let's start with the tomato. So far, no fruit on the tomato plant. The little flowers that we pollinated, that I've been pollinating, have kind of dried up. You can see no fruit has developed, but we're just going to keep on trying. Now this plant is growing and growing and growing. In fact, I figured maybe it wasn't getting enough light because the leaves down here were looking a bit yellow. So I actually added a second light up here, and I've got some more flowers developing. So we'll just keep shaking this plant to move the pollen around, and hopefully before you know it, we're gonna get a little tomato. I'd really like to get at least one tomato off this plant, and then I'm gonna transplant it outside. So far, so good on the tomato plant. Now let's move on to the cucumber. There's some really exciting things going on with the cucumber. Well, you can tell it's still growing really nicely. Now the great thing about this cucumber is it's a compact variety called the Space Master. So it probably really won't grow much taller than this cage. So it's really perfect for indoor growing. But the exciting thing is I actually have a cucumber growing on this plant. Now we did hand pollinate a little baby cucumber on the last update, which is, where did it go? It's right over here, and it actually did not take to the pollination. It dried up. It's kind of shriveled up. It's not looking good at all. So that one is not going to grow into a mature fruit. However, I did hand pollinate another little baby cucumber just a few days ago, and guess what? It's growing. So it's right over here, and I'm really hoping that within a week or so, I'll really be able to see some significant growth and maybe even have a harvest. So I'd really love to get at least one cucumber off this plant. It's really been a fun experiment, and then I'll move it out into the garden as the weather gets warmed up. But we are having a little bit of a problem. We've got some fungus gnats going on here. Now, you remember from my fungus gnat video, I said that the best cure for fungus gnats is to prevent them. Well, unfortunately, I haven't kept up on these plants. I've gotten really busy starting my warm weather seeds, working out in the garden, and these guys have gotten just a bit neglected. So we're gonna do some fungus gnat maintenance today. So I'm just gonna spray this plant down with a solution of neem oil and dish soap. So when you spray it, you wanna make sure you spray the tops of the leaves, the bottoms of the leaves, and I'm even gonna spray in the soil here because you can see all those little fungus gnats. Hopefully you can see that, those fungus gnats crawling around. And I'm also going to take some cinnamon, sprinkle some cinnamon over the soil, because that really helps. The fungus gnats don't like the cinnamon. It's an antifungal, and it will help stop them in their tracks. And I also am going to fill my little fungus gnat traps here with apple cider vinegar. I'm going to do this regularly. I'm going to spray with neem oil regularly over the next couple weeks for every 3 days, and hopefully that will take care of the problem. Now the soil is looking pretty dry here. I'm going to stick my finger in, and as far down as I can get my finger, the soil is dry. So they definitely need some water and some nutrients. So I've got a gallon jug here filled with water. About 3 to 6 ounces. I think I put about 3 ounces of the Vermistera worm tea in here because my plants need some really good nutrients, especially container plants really need to be fed about once a week. So worm tea makes a perfect liquid fertilizer, but I do want to get my plants good and soaked down so they get the nutrients they need so I can get this little cucumber developing and have a really nice harvest. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little update. I'm really happy overall with the growth that I'm seeing from my plants, and I'm certainly looking forward to harvesting this cucumber, hopefully very soon. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next update. And head over to my website, CallieKimGardenAndHome.com. I know a lot of you are really excited about spring planting, and I have a great free growing guide over there to help you get started called Grow 3 Vegetables in 6 Weeks. It's all about how to grow lettuce, peas, and beans. It's a great growing guide, very informative, beautiful color photos of my garden. I would love to have you join me over there and check out my blog as well. But comment below. I mean, this is the first time I've grown a tomato and a cucumber indoors from seed to harvest. I would love to hear any suggestions you might have for me. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.